morning, everyone. With wars in Africa and the Middle East, countries in South America fighting dictatorship, and the U.S. facing nuclear threat from North Korea, what would you say if I told you that there's an organization that brings together all but seven countries in the world? My name is Fernanda Flores. This is Caroline Meter, and we are here to inform you, St. Edward's University students, on the research we have done on the World Bank Group. The World Bank Group has more than 170 countries as its members, works with partners in the private and public sectors to fight to end poverty and most of the pressing developmental challenges in the world. Today we're going to talk about the history of the organization, the evolution of it, and also the current projects. Now I'm going to talk about the history. So according to public documents provided by the World Bank, it was first formed at the Bretton Woods Conference, and it was initially called the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. The countries that were initially part of it were the 44 allied countries of World War II at the conference. The purpose of it was for the reconstruction of Europe after World War II, and the initial countries that received the loans were France and other European nations that had infrastructure destroyed after World War II. So this is according to the Borgen Project, and they're also an international organization working to fight to end poverty. And the focus eventually shifted from reconstruction to development, and it had a heavy emphasis on the infrastructure, such as dams, electric grids, irrigation systems, and roads. Now I'm gonna hand it off to Caroline.
Thanks, Fernanda. So now that we've talked about the history, I wanna talk a little bit about the evolution of the objectives of World Bank, and then about some of the current projects that they're working on. So according to Michael Chavadovsky of the from an article in Britannica, once the European reconstruction took place in the mid-1950s, Europe started to recover from World War II, and the focus really shifted, like Fernanda said, from development or from reconstruction into development. According to The Balance, a website that covers topics of economics and finance, there were six main objectives that the World Bank came out with moving forward in their focus. One is to overcome poverty by spurring growth, to help reconstruct countries emerging from war, to help middle-income countries remain out of poverty, to support governments that are fighting climate change, improve education throughout the world, and also to publicize all the reports that they have from data that they've recovered and research that they've done. Now I want to talk a little bit about the global reach of World Bank. So we're going to talk about some of their current projects. And this is where I'm going to pull up an interactive map that World Bank has. Like Fernanda said, they're in all but seven countries in the world. This means 189 of them are members. Okay, can you see that? Okay, this is a global map of World Bank projects throughout the world. And it's mapped by the density of the projects, and this is just the African continent. If we zoom in, we can start to see the projects based on little icons, and each icon represents a different kind of project. So right now we're looking at Ethiopia right here, and you can see that there's a lot of blue. These blue icons represent projects having to do with water. Because of where Ethiopia is located, it's easy to see that at the edge of the Sahara Desert, that water is a big problem. So access to clean water is a big focus for World Bank in Ethiopia. If we want to focus on another country in a different part of the world, we could look at Turkey. And Turkey's map looks really different. So here we have a lot of green icons, a lot of finance projects that make sure that small companies have access to loans and that they can start to grow their economy. But what I really want to focus on here is the red icons. These are energy icons. Turkey is a gateway of gas from Middle East to Europe. And according to Think Geo Energy, a news source covering current events, about geothermal energy. The World Bank recently approved a $290 million package to fund development and research for geothermal energy in Turkey. So this just goes to show how diverse World Bank is, from water to energy to finance to government. Everything they're doing is to improve the infrastructure, improve the lives of people in these countries, and to help their economy grow. And so even though Turkey is a really important gas country that transports gas throughout the region, it's also a country that's developing alternative energy. And World Bank has a big part in that. And this is just a really small piece of, in the big picture of what World Bank does. We barely scratched the surface. But I'm gonna hand it over to Fernanda. We'll go back to the PowerPoint. And she can finish it up for us. So in conclusion, we talked about the history of the World Bank and why it was formed. And later on, we talked about the evolution of the organization and the development of it and its current projects. And finally, we talked about the current projects and compared it in different countries and the ongoing projects within them. That's it. Thank you for your time. And do you have any questions?